What's game-changing about WebAssembly is that it brings the performance of native applications to the web in a way that's completely secure, yet enables the full functionality you expect from games, major applications, the entire spectrum of software you can run on a computer.
The main problem that WebAssembly is aiming to solve is that while we have JavaScript on the web, which is a great language, it wasn't really designed to be fast to start up a very large application. WebAssembly just built as a binary format that's very compact to download and also very efficient to compile and execute. WebAssembly should give us big speed ups in two main areas. The first is in startup speed.
We've already seen applications start 2x or more faster, and there's a whole bunch of optimizations coming that will drive that even further, allowing huge applications to load up quickly even on mobile devices.
In addition, we should get significant benefits in throughput too. That is, the code, once it's compiled, will run faster.
WebAssembly fills the gap of high-performance execution without needing to choose any kind of plugins.
So now with WebAssembly, we can have you know real 64-bit integer data types. The other thing is more control over memory management in general, something we couldn't do before.
You're going to see a lot more smooth performance throughout the life of the application as you use it, without kind of the stutters and janks that can happen due to different JIT or garbage collection heuristics.
WebAssembly now means that developers of all types can bring their native C applications and C++ applications to the web and achieve full performance and the full set of capabilities that they have running native on Windows or Mac just in a web browser, which is revolutionary because it means now users can just go to a web page and start using the app. No download, no installation, no security risk. It's a really revolutionary approach.
You click on a URL, get this huge scene, you're straight into your immersive experience. And you get close to native performance, but portable across platforms using a browser. That's awesome.
Being able to write your code in one language and then port it to all the platforms, that's definitely huge engineering advantages.
We have a format which we can use as a compilation target for C++ or other languages.
That's one exciting direction, is we just keep adding to the feature set of WebAssembly until we're able to efficiently capture all the major languages.
The idea of having a universal compile target that could eventually unlock the ability for any language to target it. Well, what's more open than that?
Being able to run natively on the web in JavaScript using WebGL as we do now, a lot of people wouldn't have believed a few years ago.
Frankly, when I started on this path of trying to compile code to the web, I actually didn't even know if it could work.
I thought it was just completely nuts.
The coolest reaction was we were at Epic porting, their Citadel demo, and we were there for 1 week, and on the very last day in the morning, we got it compiled as asm.js. We were working at JavaScript, but using the new asm.js path, we were able to get it working that morning, and it was running, super smoothly, smoother than anything we'd seen before on any browser. And so, there's a great moment with hugging and high-fiving. Tim Sweeney had been notified that, oh my goodness, his engine was running in a web browser and getting pretty good performance. And so he was standing there looking at it. Overnight, we had gone from kind of what you might have expected, which was kind of stuttery, it's making it, to butter smooth. I remember him saying something to the effect of I thought this would be possible, but not so soon.
This is an amazing development, a great development for the future of the web, and Mozilla has been at the core of it.
Other types of applications, they have a moderately fixed workload. In games, generally, if you're able to provide 20% more of performance, games generally can translate that to 20% more content.
We started to work with those groups knowing that they would have the most punishing requirements. And so what this does is give us a lot of confidence that when people start to use it in other use cases that aren't nearly as punishing as the games industry, they're going to have a lot of success at it.
And for us, with the Stingray engine, not only is it a cutting-edge game engine, but at Autodesk, we use Stingray to create immersive experiences for architects, for mechanical engineers. That means that it will apply, right? This technology is transferable to all the markets that we serve.
This entire train of development that began with asm.js and now has led to WebAssembly is, to me, the ultimate culmination of web development capabilities. It's a new step in accessibility. It's beyond anything achieved previously.
I guess you could say Mozilla has only the web.
We're seeing more and more platforms move towards walled gardens, and I see the web being one of the remaining, or maybe the only remaining space where there's no entity controlling what can be published or not. And I think that's very important to maintain.
We want the web to be able to provide all the things that people need. So I think that sort of forced us to take a hard look and say, well, what needs to be done to allow this?
WebAssembly is one of the first times we've seen all four browsers sit down at the table from the beginning of a standard.
The web only works because a bunch of different companies who make browsers and operating systems cooperate together to define its future. When some of these companies are cutthroat competitors, it's hard for them to work together directly, and Mozilla has played an amazing role in facilitating cooperation there.
You know, at Mozilla, really opening up the web platform is what we're all about and keeping it that way, and we're just, you know, inviting a whole new slew of skill sets to the web in a way that just wasn't possible before. So for us, that's a real step forward for the web.